Okay, so tell me, George, what this meeting was all about and what you see going on from here.
Well, I think
forward.
This meeting, I think, illustrates, in my opinion, the best example in our state of business, labor, and government working together to fund programs that really do enhance the business community, raise the skills of workers, raise the literacy rate of workers, so that our businesses and our workforce can compete in this troubled economy. This has been going on for almost 20 years now. We were innovative in taking some of the funds from the Unemployment Insurance Fund to fund this. And as you can see from the examples here today, it is a tremendous success in the business community and really should be expanded.
How much money are we talking about?
The fund raises about $13 million a year.
And where does that come from?
And that comes from a diversion from the Unemployment Insurance Fund. It's called the Job Development Fund. Mm-hmm. So the employers are actually funding this, and the theory behind it was to use some of the unemployment insurance funds to intervene early so that people will not become unemployed. And that's the theory behind it, and it's worked very well.
Now, Charlie, you're not entirely new to doing all of this, but what do you see happening here?
Well, this is a great, as George mentioned, a great collaboration. And to get our state where we need to be in terms of the skill of the workforce, we need all partners, business, labor, government, the nonprofit sector, working together. And the great thing about this is that the business community funds this themselves. They chose to do this, and it's business driven. It's not somebody saying, here, this is what we're going to do, you fit into it. It's business saying, here are the opportunities, here's what we need to happen. Help us partner to get these skills embedded in people so that the workforce is there when we expand.
Do you see any, you know, where's the job growth going to be?
Well, we have five partnerships that we look at, because it's important that when you have training programs, that they're for jobs that exist now or will exist in the future. So things such as hospitality, such as healthcare, bioengineering, marine trades, opportunities that are there now, but more importantly, that are the growth industries that Rhode Island is going to look to in the future.